I've managed to get my stories out to the world, except for this time when the revolt began. We were given clear instructions to follow the directives and not cross the so-called red lines, and we were given press releases from the Interior Ministry that said that there were foreign agents fomenting the unrest, also that the Muslim Brotherhood, Egypt's largest opposition party or group, outlawed but tolerated, were behind all of these protests. They had instigated this revolt, and that these were people who were betraying their country and causing instability. And that I chose to walk out because I didn't want to be part of the propaganda machine of this regime, particularly after I'd seen the atrocities committed. I was following closely, watching the satellite channels, and I saw the horrible crimes committed, and they had blood on their hands, and I just didn't want to be implicated in their crimes.
Ms. Amin, we have been reporting since the beginning of the revolution this incredible contrast between what we saw in the streets and what Nile TV was reporting. You just referred to a red line that you could not cross. What is the red line?
Red lines was, we couldn't call this a revolution as it was. We weren't allowed to cover the protests in Tahrir Square and listen to the demands of the anti-regime protesters. They were downplaying the whole thing as if it was just a rally against the high prices following the economic downturn. And also, after that, when that didn't work, they started attacking the protesters, calling them hired agents and saying that they were given money to do this. So I wasn't able to go cover that. And for me, as a journalist, here was history in the making in my own backyard, and I wasn't allowed to go out and report. So you can imagine what that was like.